This is Roosevelt with Auto Network. I'm here in Nashville, Tennessee with Dodge for the launch of the 2013 Ram 1500. We're here at the Marathon Music Works where we'll start the presentation. Journalists are just coming in from the hotel. We were shuttled over in the vans. There's one of the vans leaving now. You can see a 1500 here. And we're getting ready to go inside the Marathon Music Works for our presentation. Then we'll hit the road as usual, do some off-roading, on-roading. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you on the road.
As the guys mentioned, Ryan Nagode, chief of our Dodge Ram Fiat SRT Interiors. Obviously, it's great to be here. I've been with Ram and the Ram truck program from its inception in 2009 with our all-new truck. And that's one of the best parts about, you know, what we got the chance to do in the 13 was really have a great foundation with the current truck. So it was all about listening to customer feedback, going in and doing things that even we really, really wanted to do internally. And so I'm going to take you through, you know, as much of that as I can in the time allowed. But again, obviously, any questions later on, I'll be here the whole day. So two main focuses, materials, color materials, and technology. Both of those, you know, changes that we've done have attacked then obviously all the surface work. So I'm going to kind of go over some of the key points, and obviously this buck's great. Gives you guys a chance to really see into the interior. Obviously it's hard to crowd around a truck sometimes. So one of the big areas was doors. You're going to notice a lot of work in terms of our door treatments. Felt maybe that was one of the areas that we got close in the current truck, but we really wanted to take to the next level. And you're going to see that from the properties that we, you know, we brought for you guys to really see between the lineup. So doors, front to rear is huge. Center stack, obviously a lot of technology upgrades there to that area. So there's a lot of great nuggets of kind of cool things in terms of how we've gone in and done a lot more layering with some of the materials and finishes. It really gives a nice high-end premium look. Even on some of our products like our SLT, which obviously is one of our high runners. We've done a lot of work on our 20% seat bench versions. Obviously, that's not the one that's up here now. When you see that today, we've redesigned the cup holder in that area in terms of functionality. It was one customer feedback item that we wanted to hit, and we made sure that we attacked it there. As well as other items in the console, because of our technology upgrades, our new Uconnect system, we have all media hubs, media ports, all located in that common area, as well as a nice 12-volt power outlet, in some conditions, powered USB. So all in that area. And then to top it off, we've redone all the vents. So in terms of easy to use, quality level, we're trying to obviously do as much as we can in terms of quality to keep that up to that high echelon. So overall, in terms of color materials, you can see this is every one of our models on the board. And I think having this display really helps to show that we have as much unique and differentiation as that Joe talked about in the exterior. We have that in the interior as well. So we've really gone through it and made sure that we're upgrading things that we knew we needed to do. So on SLT, we made sure the fabrics on SLT feel a little softer to the touch. I know some of the comments in the past have been a little bit too sandy. So that's some of the things we really want to focus on. And now we actually have two versions of that interior as well. So when you get like a Bighorn, a Lone Star, more of that premium SLT, you actually do get a premium cloth as well for that interior. Sport, redid the mesh fabric on Sport just to really complement the exterior work that Joe's team has done on that. So it's a really pretty cool feature. It was one of these trucks out there today. Overall, in terms of Laramie, we've upped the quality level in terms of the leather. So it has a much more supple feel to it. And I think overall, that's one of the things that the Longhorn product, when we launched it, really showed that there's not that high of a thing, but the ceiling is pretty high in terms of what you can put into a truck, in terms of a luxury pickup truck. And we wanted to really sprinkle some of that down into the lower trim models, and then I think you'll see that when you go through the lineup. Longhorn, we've retained that trim model, but one of the things we've done overall is colors in terms of that. We've really punched the colors up a little bit. The browns are a little bit more red. Our lighter tones are a little lighter, a little bit more open. So across the board, we've done that for all of the color materials. So moving on, I want to touch a little bit on some specifics. I'm going to use some of the little partials here. So one of the other things in terms of color materials we wanted to attack is Longhorn. That is our premium truck. We want to make sure that all the materials that went into that truck, you know, have that level of quality. So one of the things we wanted to do was wood and real wood. So we've thrown in the real wood for both of our Longhorn interiors. And it's not just a normal wood in terms of a high glossy wood. It's actually an open pore wood. So you actually can feel the grain of that wood. And it's a low gloss, feels more natural. I think it fits really well for the Longhorn. Now that wood's kind of got some unique character and history as well too. It's a wood from a European source. That wood is actually used as fence posts. So they wrap barbed wire around that fence post. This wood normally would look pretty plain. So over the years that that wood starts growing, that tree starts growing, and it engulfs the barbed wire. That barbed wire then starts to deteriorate inside, and that's actually what's creating the swirling effect that you see in the final product. Happens 1 in 1 million trees, so it's a pretty upper echelon in terms of wood usage. We thought that was perfect for the Longhorn. It's finished in 2 stains to match the interior colors, and we've updated those interior colors on Longhorn specifically. So that kind of caps off our materials. I'm going to use the same property to talk a little bit about technology. So the guys mentioned two of the big ones is our 7-inch multi-view cluster. So the property here has it. A plethora of the trucks out there, if you guys go to drive, have that cluster. It's a full color 7-inch TFT. So obviously it allows you to have an infinite amount of information all at your fingertips. One of the cool features is specifically truck related. You hook a trailer up to it. It actually comes up with a screen that's got all the information pertinent to trailer towing. Obviously that's great. You can flip through a few other options for that screen. There's literally over 350 screens that you can go through and customize. There's 4 quadrants of that TFT, which you can go through and customize in terms of temperature, maybe your trip, and all that stuff can be all up there right in front and center.
Thin film transistor, if you're wondering.
Yes, thin film transistor. You can also add a few other gauges too on the side. So obviously, a ton of talk about there. Encourage you guys to obviously play with the trucks when you're out there today. We do have then as well our mid-level and entry-level cluster. And really, for the most part, it's actually our premium cluster for today's truck. So it's got a 3.5-inch display, which obviously allows even the entry-level trucks to have a really nice display in front of them. The 7-inch TFT is optional on SLT, standard on Sport, Laramie, and Long. Our second item, our big 8.4-inch touchscreen. So obviously, the benefits of that are a super huge display. Easy to use. We're pulling it again from Charger Journey 300 in terms of its intuitiveness. But the key with this 8.4-inch screen is the next generation version of that system. So we're bringing in some features like downloadable apps, which we can get into a little bit later. We'll have some product specialists to kind of answer some questions, obviously, as you guys are playing. But in terms of some other things that are more design related on it, one of the cool things you're going to notice, and hopefully you jump between trucks, you go into a Longhorn, actually that background of that 8.4-inch screen is going to match the interior. So some of you guys can kind of see on this one, it's got that brown tone to it. It's actually got a Longhorn in the background. You go into an SLT, maybe more it's a gray tone with a big RAM set. And actually that's all happening, you know, the screens are actually preloaded. It reads the VIN number of the truck and automatically pulls up the background. So again, it reads in and pulls in the colors that we've done. So that's kind of a cool design feature that the 8.4-inch next generation system has. One of the big keys, these guys are going to talk about fuel economy. One of the neighbors with fuel economy is obviously our Torque Flight 8-speed transmission. That requires electronic shifting. And obviously that was one of the keys with the truck, is we had to come up with something that would necessitate that electronic shifting. So we decided to do a rotary G-shifter. Spent a lot of time in terms of research clinics, trying to make sure that we were finding the most intuitive, easy to use device that we could. Also with the truck, you know, we obviously have a lot of configurations. So we had to find a place that made sense in terms of bucket and a bench seat configuration. So the rotary E-shift on the center stack is the best place. Again, it's easy in terms of the can go to park to drive, almost in a blind operation. Obviously, it's key when you're going back and forward, maybe you're in a ditch, make sure you're getting out of it pretty easily to use. So again, we have about 5 to 6 trucks that are Hemi versions of that. And there's a lot of V6 versions out there today. There are 2 versions of that knob. So as you see on premium trucks, in our Sport, Laramie, and Long Run, they have a nice metal knob, casted metal, so it really feels premium. A nice, you know, easy in terms of 4 positions, 4 detents. And then you can see at the end there on the ST, we have a rubber overmold version on our ST and SLT trucks. Right below that, you have your transfer case. So when you do get the rotary E-shift, it's a 4 push button transfer case. We want to make sure that we weren't putting 2 rotary dials obviously right next to each other, so you definitely knew that you had 1 for E-shift and 1 for transfer case. Some other notables in terms of the center stack is we've redone all of our HVAC controls in terms of the controls that speak to the center stack. There are a few key ones that are redundant. Most of that stuff can be found in the 8.4 inch screen. We want to make sure that, especially for the truck customer, there was a few easy to push buttons. Obviously, maybe you got your gloves on. That's something that you want to be able to do. Right below that, we are a huge multi-gang switch bank. So some of the new content features the guys are going to talk about, air suspension, buttons located there. Trailer brake, we used to have it on the left side of the dash. We've now moved that to the center area. The top bank over here is function buttons. The lower bank is your comfort buttons in terms of ventilated seats, heated steering wheel. So everything's really nicely grouped into one key area. Obviously, it's perfect. You don't have to take your eyes off and you don't have to be looking around. That was key. So really with that, you know, I just want to make sure that you guys are aware that obviously from a design size, as the other guys mentioned, we have a great looking truck, I think inside and out. We want to make sure we're taking it though to the next level. We're not going to sit back on our laurels. So definitely take a look at all these models later today, and I'll be around for any questions. With that, I'm going to throw it over to Mike Raymond to talk about the nuts and bolts.